Right, good afternoon students. Today I am going to complete the tangent normal. The angle of intersection. The angle of intersection. The angle of intersection of the curves. The angle of intersection of the curves y equal to step mod sin x plus mod cos x. Mod sin x plus mod cos x and x square plus y square equal to 5 is where is greatest integer function. Once this symbol stands for greatest integer function, the angle of intersection of the curves y equal to step of mod sin x plus mod cos x and the circle x square plus y square equal to 5 is. So this is the question. For this, let us consider the circle as the first curve. Circle as first curve. Differentiating with respect to x. We get 2x plus 2y divided by dx is clearly 0. So that dy by dx from this relation, that is minus x by y, minus x by y. Similarly, C2 is the curve y equal to step mod sin x plus mod cos x, step mod sin x plus mod cos x. Once you observe this mod sin x plus mod cos x, whatever may be the value of x, that is always greater than 1 and less than 2. Because once you take x equal to 0, mod sin x plus mod cos x is 1. Because for x equal to 0, this is 0 and this is 1. For x equal to pi by 4, correspondingly we get 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2, that is root 2. Root 2 is more than 1, greater than 1. Similarly, for x equal to pi by 3, 16, this is root 3 by 2 and whereas this is 1 by 2. This value is root 3 plus 1 by 2, more than 1 and less than 2. So, like that, once you take x equal to pi by 2, this is 1 and this is 0. So, that is 1. Suppose x equal to pi, this one is minus 1, mod minus 1 is 1, this is 0, so it takes 1. Like that, the value never more than 2, the never more than 2, but greater than or equal to 1. So, this value lies between 1 and 2. Hence, this it takes the value y equal to, that is y equal to 1. Since mod sin x plus mod cos x value always lies between 1 and 2, it cannot take the value 2. But it is must be more than 1 and or 1. That implies any value that lies between 1 and 2, its step value takes the integer value. The maximum integer involved in this one is 1, left hand value. So hence, y equal to step mod sin x plus mod cos x means it is nothing but y equal to 1 itself. This is C2. This is C1. Now, Let us consider the graph of the curves. This is our C1, the circle having its center at origin, whose radius is root 5. Y equal to 1, is a line parallel to x-axis and above x-axis. Y equal to 1, this length is 1. This length is 1 unit. So, it intersects the curve at 2 points. Taking y equal to 1 here, x takes the value 2. So, this is the point 2 comma 1, whereas this is the point minus 2 comma 1. So, y equal to 1 intersects, the curve, the circle in 2 points, that is 2 comma 1 and minus 2 comma 1. So, here intersection points or intersection points are points of C1 comma C2 are clearly 2, 1, minus 2 comma 1. At this point you have to find the angle between these two. Here the slope of C2 divided by x is here. In this case divided by x is 0. So, at 2 comma 1, therefore m1 divided by x of curve 1 at 2 comma 1 is minus 2 by 1. M2 divided by x of C2 at the point, same point, that is 0, because this is 0. Based on M1 and M2, the angle between the curves, acute angle, of course, acute angle between curves. C2 is given by theta equal to tan inverse of modulus of M1 minus M2 by 1 plus M1 M2. That is tan inverse of M1 is minus 2, 0 by 1 plus 0 here. M1 into M2 is 0. That gives us tan inverse of 2. Similarly, you can find the angle at minus 2 comma 1 also. In such case, it gives us 2. Hence, we get 2 here. In such case also, the acute angle is tan inverse 2 itself. So, the angle between the given two intersecting curves is clearly tan inverse 2. In this problem, this one is very important. The curve is, evaluation of the curve is more important. It's a nice problem, very simple, but one should evaluate this one. Next. Next problem. This is one important problem, very important, of course, this concept. The point on the curve (3x²-4y²=72). Which is nearest to, the line, the point on the curve which is nearest to the line, 3x plus 2y plus 1 equal to 0 is. the point on the curve 3x square minus 4y square equal to 72, which is nearest to the line. This is clearly a hyperbola. That is clearly a hyperbola, of course. Suppose the hyperbola is like this. This is one line. That is one line. Let us suppose that line is like this. The nearest point to the, and the nearest point on the nearest point on the curve to the line. This point to be needed. The nearest point on the curve, let it be, this is x1, y1. Now, this should be the perpendicular distance. This should be a perpendicular distance. That means this is a normal to the curve as well as to the line. The nearest distance obtained between any two curves, the nearest distance obtained between any two curves along their common normal. That is the worth note point here. Once you have two curves, the nearest distance between the two curves is along their normal only. That is the first worth note point. The nearest distance, the closest distance, nearest, the nearest distance between two given curves is along their common normal, itself. That is worth note point. The nearest distance between two curves is always along their common normal. Hence, normal means here one curve is a straight line. Normal means it is a perpendicular line to this line. And this is also a normal at this point. So, the perpendicular to the line where it meets the curve is needed here. Because this is a normal to the curve as well as normal or perpendicular to this line. That should be observed. For that, here C1, the curve 1 is 3x square minus 4y square equal to 70. Differentiating with respect to x. Differentiating with respect to x, 6x. Minus 8y divided by dx is 0. Therefore, divided by dx is 6x by 8y, that is 3x by 4y. Let us suppose the required point which is nearest to the line. Again, let C2 is the other curve is the line. Slope of this line is minus 3 by 2. Slope of that line is minus 3 by 2. Since this is normal to the curve, at x1, y1. The tangent at this point is parallel to this line. Here, since normal at the required point is perpendicular to the given line. Since normal at required point on the curve is perpendicular to given line C2, hence C2 is parallel to tangent at the required point. This is most important. So at the required point, the given line is parallel to the tangent. Hence, dy by dx must be equal to here, the slope of the tangent, the slope of the line itself, because the tangent at required point is parallel to that line. Once the tangent drawn at the point, is parallel to this line, of course, these two are parallel, then only this is, this normal is also normal to this line. Therefore, 3x by 4y takes the value minus 3 by 2. From this, this is x equal to minus 2y. Let us suppose the point is x1, y1. The point is x1, y1. Let that point, required point is x1, y1. In such case, the derivative at x1, y1 is 3 by 2. The derivative at x1, y1 is 3 by 2. Hence, x1 equal to minus 2, y1. Moreover, x1, y1 lies on the curve. Moreover, x1, y1 lies on C1. That implies 3x1 square minus 4y1 square equal to 72. This is one more condition in x1, y1. Solving these two, immediately you get x1, y1. So therefore, 3x1 square minus y1 in terms of x1 is minus x1 by 2 whole square equal to 72. So that 2x1 square takes the value 72. X1 square is 36. So x1 takes the value plus or minus 6. Once x1 equal to plus or minus 6, y1 equal to. So y1 equal to minus 2 into y1 equal to minus x1 by 2, that is plus or minus 6 by 2 means minus or plus 3. So the required point x1, y1 is required point is 6, minus 3 or minus 6, 3. So based on the options, you can take either 6, minus 3 or minus 6, 3. Now observe the perpendicular distance from 6, minus 3 and minus 6, 3 to this line, perpendicular distance. Whichever is smaller, that we can consider that point. So here, perpendicular distance from 6, minus 3 to C2 is, the line is, that is 18 minus 6 plus 1 by 9 plus 4, which gives us 12 plus 1, 13 by root 13, that is root 13. Similarly, to perpendicular distance from minus 6, 3 to C2 is modulus of minus 18 plus 2 plus 1 by plus 6, this is 6, 3 into 2, plus 6 plus 1 by, this is root 13 itself. In this case, this is 11 by root 13. So out of these two, the smaller one is this, 11 by root 13. The smaller distance is this. So out of these two points, one should consider minus 6, 3. So the next one is rejected and we shall consider only minus 6, 3. That is the smallest that is the point on the curve which is a closer point to the given line. So this concept is a very good concept. Equating the derivative of the curve to the slope of the line, because the tangent drawn at that required point is parallel to that line, then only the curve and the line has a common normal at that particular required point. Based on that, we get a relation between x1, y1, the coordinates of the required point. Similarly, x1, y1 lies on the curve. From that, we get one more relation in terms of x1, y1. Solving both these, we get the points. Out of the obtained points, one should observe which point is closer to the line based on the perpendicular distance formula. Here clearly -6,3 is that smallest distance or nearest distance. Hence, we shall consider that point as the required point. Such problems are very important problems. This point is more important for any two curves. For any two curves, the shortest distance, unless and otherwise they are not intersecting. Once they are intersecting, the nearest distance is zero. Once they are not intersecting, you can say that the shortest distance between the curves is along their common normal only. That is very worth note point. Next problem. This is also one important problem. If the tangent at x0, y0 at x0, y0 to the curve x cube, this is x cube plus y cube equal to a cube, meets the curve again at x1, y1, then the value of x1 by x0 plus y1 by y0 equal to. If the tangent at x0, y0 to this particular curve, x cube plus y cube equal to a cube, meets the curve again at x1, y1, then x1 by x0 plus y1 by y0 value. Suppose, let it be this is the curve, cubic curve. A tangent is drawn at x0, y0. A tangent is drawn at x0, y0. Intersects the curve again at x1, y1. In such case, you have to find the value of x1 by x0 plus y1 by y0. Once the tangent intersects the curve at x1, y1, the slope of this line to be equal to derivative obtained from the curve, because derivative gives us the tangent. Derivative at x0, y0 gives us the slope of that tangent. That should be equal to slope of this chord, because this is the chord. These two points lies on the curve. So hence, based on this, let us consider at first the curve x cube plus y cube equal to a cube. x0, y0 and x1, y1 lies on the curve. Lies on the curve itself. Therefore, x0 cube plus y0 cube equal to a cube and x1 cube plus y1 cube equal to a cube. Both the points satisfies the curve. From this subtraction, x1 cube minus x0 cube plus y1 cube minus y0 cube equal to 0. Subtraction of these two conditions, we get x1 cube minus x0 cube plus y1 cube minus y0 cube equal to 0. From this, x1 minus x0 into x1 square plus x1 x0 plus x0 square plus y1 minus y0 into y1 square plus y1 y0 plus y0 square is 0. Just I am factorizing the terms because a cube minus b cube, a cube minus b cube may be written as a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. So that y1 from this y1 minus y0 by x1 minus x0 value. y1 minus y0, transfer that term to that side and taking y1 minus y0 by x1 minus x0, which gives us minus of x1 square plus x1 x0 plus x0 square by y1 square plus y1 y0 plus y0 square. This is one relation or second relation, second one. Clearly, y1 minus y0 by x1 minus x0 gives us the slope of the tangent at x0, y0. But from 1, differentiating with respect to x, we get 3x square plus 3y square dy by dx is 0. Therefore, dy by dx at x0, y0. Because the tangent is drawn at x0, y0. The slope of the tangent is x0 square by y0 square. This is also the slope of the same one. 1 and 2 represents the slope of same line. 1 and 2 represents the slope of same line. 2 and 3. From 2 and 3, we get x0 square by y0 square equal to minus of x1 square plus x1 x0 plus x0 square by y1 square plus y1 y0 plus y0 square. Since slopes are equal. Since this is the slope of tangent at x0, y0, at the same time, the slope of the tangent at x0, y0 is also obtained from the points y1 minus y0 by x1 minus x0. Based on this, on simplification, we get the required result. So that, therefore, x0 square into y1 square plus y1 y0 plus y0 square equal to, this is y0 square into x1 square plus x1 x0 plus x0 square. So, x0 square into y1 square plus x0 square into y1 y0 plus x0 square y0 square equal to x1 square y0 square plus x1 x0 y0 square plus x0 square y0 square. This term cancel. Now collecting remaining terms. Collecting, otherwise dividing both sides with x0 square and y0 square. Now dividing both sides by x0 square into y0 square, we get, dividing this one with x0 square, y0 square, we get y1 square by y0 square. Dividing with x0 square, y0 square, y1 by y0 we get here. Similarly here, x1 square by x0 square plus here we get that y0 square cancel, x1 by x0. Okay. Now that is x1 square by x0 minus y1 square by y0 square. X1 square by x0 square minus y1 square by y0 square. Here is also dividing with x0, y0. We get y1 by y0. Okay. Dividing with x0, y0. 1 x0 cancel and y0 square cancel. This is x1. This is x1. Okay. So, taking these terms to this side, we get x1 by x0 minus y1 by y0 equal to 0. Clearly, x1 by x0 minus y1 by y0 is a factor to both the terms. X1 by x0 plus y1 by y0 minus 1. This is plus 1, of course, taking this term equal to 0. Therefore, x1 by x0 plus y1 by y0 takes the value minus 1. This is the required result. So, x1 by x0, x1 by x0 plus y1 by y0 equal to minus 1 is the required result. This is one such result. Because on joining these two points, we get a line segment. Since both the points lies on the curve, the joining line segment slope is given by y1 minus y0 by x1 minus x0, which is the slope of the tangent at x0, y0. So, I am equating these two results, these two. On simplification, we get the required result. X1 by x0 plus y1 by y0 equal to minus 1. This is one important form problem. Okay.